Please rise for the singing of our national anthem. Please be seated. Before we begin our opening remarks, I would like to alert everyone in attendance that there are three exits from the field in case of emergency. The main gate to my left that everyone entered this evening, the gate behind the bleachers to my right, and on the opposite side of the field away from the bleachers to my right. When Mr. Dorr brought Andrew, Kara, and me into his office to tell us what we would have to do in order to prepare for these speeches, he introduced them as welcome speeches. However, he said they have evolved into graduation speeches, and nobody actually says welcome anymore. I believe that there is a reason for this. Almost 4 years ago, we entered the high school's hallways, some of us timid and others bold, but all of us in a brand new environment. We stand here today, about to receive our diplomas, feeling right in our own places. I do not need to welcome anyone here tonight, our friends, family, or peers, because this is our home. We have grown, accomplished, failed, and persevered through hardships here together. Here in our Hopewell Valley home, we have made many amazing memories. I was recently reading a novel by the renowned author Tad Williams, where he explains to never make your home in a place. Make a home for yourself inside your own head. You'll find what you need to furnish it. Memory, friends you can trust, love of learning, and other such things. That way, it will go with you wherever you journey. I believe that we have furnished our homes with all of these things. We screamed with our friends or teammates at the football state championship. We sat through many long lectures that we could not have believed lasted under an hour. And we hosted the cleanest welcome back in the history of Hopewell Valley Central High School. On the other hand, unlike Williams suggests, we made our home in a place, at this high school. The exciting and scary truth of it all is that we must become the freshmen once more at the school, program, job, or other plan we are moving on to. The challenge we face is in further extending our home. We will encounter so many new things in our future years that our home is going to be crammed full of so much furniture. We should all change our homes by getting that new furniture we've always wanted and by cleaning out all the regrets and mistakes we may have accumulated over the past couple of years. I stand here today not to welcome you, but to say goodbye for now. Because no matter where our physical house is in the future, Our home is who we are. Our foundations were built here, but the large structures and additions that are to come will extend outside our community. When we leave here today, I'm expecting to walk down memory lane, looking at everyone's huge new mansions and seeing just how this community has made a home all over the world. Congratulations, everyone, and good luck.
Dr. Smith, board members, Mr. Dare, faculty, family, and friends. Class of 2014, we did it. The day we have waited for is finally here. After all the late nights of studying, writing essay after essay, Mr. O'Brien, hours of homework, midterms, and finals, we have finally reached the finish line. But we couldn't have done it all alone. Parents, thank you for inspiring us, believing in us, and sacrificing for us. This is as much your moment as it is ours. You are our rocks and our role models. To our administration, thank you for creating an environment where all students feel welcome, regardless of what life has dealt them or what mistakes we have made. And teachers, thank you for making our dreams into a reality, for inspiring us to go above and beyond and never giving up on us. Most importantly, thank you for the gift of an education. Every one of you has had a significant difference in all of our lives and made each of us feel special. Looking back on all of our accomplishments, what other schools can say they have had the opportunity to visit orphanages in Kenya, win the football state championship, perform Broadway quality renditions of plays, raise tens of thousands of dollars for breast cancer by hosting a tailgate, or building a working robot? I mean, come on, a robot. Hopewell, we are amazing. We are one of a kind. There is no other high school student body who bleeds school spirit the way we do. However, now we must let go of what we know and what we are used to and go out into the world. The world seems like a scary place. Statistics show that interest rates are rising, unemployment is still high, graduate school has become a requirement instead of a choice, and the world is a scary place, if you're a statistic. But we are anything but a statistic or a number. Statistics don't account for the power of our dreams, the drive that gets us out of bed at 6 in the morning, or the dedication that makes us want to better ourselves and the world around us. If we hold what this school and this community has taught us close to our hearts, we will overcome any and all of life's obstacles. And when life knocks you down, remember you can always bounce back. While driving through LBI this past Memorial Day, I finally realized what it meant to be Jersey strong. This kind of strength means overcoming life's hardest obstacles, rebuilding when it seems impossible, and never giving up when it seems like everything is crashing down. It's who we are. Statistics said that it would take years to rebuild the wreckage done by Hurricane Sandy. What statistics predicted would take years to do, we did in months. You can take the bulldog out of Hopewell, but you can never take the bulldog out of the graduate. Getting to know each one of you these past few years, I've realized that each one of you has a special gift to share with the world. Don't be afraid to show the world your talent. I am so proud of each and every one of you and everything we've accomplished together. Now let's get out there and start shedding those statistics. Thank you.
Hello, and welcome faculty, families, friends, and of course the Hopewell Valley class of 2014. When I first sat down to write this speech, I had trouble thinking of what to say to inspire everyone in our endeavors beyond our high school years. But then I realized, we have already been bred for success because we have been bred as bulldogs. Bulldogs are smaller than most dogs, but they are capable of putting on a tough face and tackling any obstacle, no matter how big. We have learned to take chances. Since the chances we have taken in our past and the ones we will surely take in our future come with both success and failure, it is important that we learn from our actions. Although not perfect, we are constantly adapting based on our experiences. Our mistakes have taught us lessons, and now we will graduate as trained bulldogs. Lastly, one of the most important characteristics of bulldogs is that we are not afraid to discover new places and to roll around in the mud when necessary. We have learned to explore and to get messy. All of these things that make us Bulldogs are the things that will make us successful in our years to come. So, Bulldogs class of 2014, never forget, if what you want lies buried, dig until you find it. Avoid biting when a simple growl will do. When you leave your yard, make it a worthwhile adventure. Never pretend to be something you're not. Be loyal. And when loved ones come home, always run to greet them. As long as we remember to be a Bulldog and take chances, learn from mistakes, and have a little fun in the process, nothing will faze us. So go out there and show everyone the kind of dogs we have been raised to be. Good luck, class of 2014, and know that once a Bulldog, always a Bulldog.
Dr. Smith, Mr. Dare, faculty, parents, and students. I struggled to speak during my preschool years. In my special education program, I was given a special electronic computer to help me communicate. As you can see, my speech therapists and teachers did their job well. My journey of education began with early intervention, speech and occupational therapy, and lots of walks around the school beer tavern to help me calm down during moments of feeling anxious. Being in a big classroom in kindergarten was overwhelming for me, but it was at beer tavern where I began to learn to pay attention, read, write, draw, and communicate with others. You see, I have Asperger's syndrome. It is a condition that makes it difficult for me to process some information. I also get easily distracted and sometimes have laughing episodes from funny things I remember in movies and television shows. Communicating with people and understanding social cues are a struggle for me as well. I view Asperger's syndrome in many ways as a gift because it makes me who I am. To all my peer buddies from elementary, middle, and high school, thank you for helping me on the playground, on the track at Timber Lane, and throughout all of my inclusion classes at Central High School. You all supported me, were patient when my Asperger's caused me to laugh uncontrollably. You helped me to learn important skills that will help me succeed in the adult world. As I look ahead to the future, I think about what happened during the past 4 years at Central High School. Everybody has memories, in which some stand out more than others, that we will take with us on our new life adventures. I will remember walking in the auditorium on the first day of freshman year, being introduced to the staff in the school, and meeting new friends along the way. I was very happy on that day because I knew I would have an opportunity to build my skills and share my talents. I was a little anxious because I didn't know exactly what to expect. I took high school day by day, and I soon enjoyed the experience of being with my teachers and classmates. During my 4 years, I worked hard to develop my social skills with the other students. I would say hello to friends in the hallway and talk with them during lunch. Every year, I did cross country and track in the spring, where I made more friends and improved my running. The coaches and teammates supported me with every stride taken. My classes also were very interesting. I went on many field trips with my transition team to learn more about life. I am confident I will reach my goals of graduating from college, living on my own, and pursuing my dreams as an adult. I am thankful to the staff, my parents, and friends at Hopewell Valley who have helped make my journey so positive. In the words of the famous runner, Wilma Rudolph, quote, "Never underestimate the power of dreams and the influence of the human spirit." We are all the same in this notion. The potential for greatness lives within each of us. I am an example that our differences make us authentic. And being authentic makes us who we are and who we can become in this life. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. I know that for many people, public speaking is very daunting, but how could you not get excited about speaking to your classmates? I'm thrilled to have been given the opportunity to speak today and tell all of our friends and family about the many accomplishments of the class of 2014. This very well-rounded class has made strides in everything ranging from athletics to academics to the arts. However, what's even more impressive than the awards this class has received are the incredibly big dreams and unrivaled work ethic of every single student. I'm up here today because I want to share with you the pride that I have in the class of 2014. When I wrote this speech, I knew I wanted it to be factual. So I went online and did what any good student would do: consult reliable academic sources. So I looked to the dictionary for help. UrbanDictionary.com, a popular resource for definitions of slang terms, defines Hopewell Valley as a small town full of hippies, wannabes, hypocrites, and posers, all with one thing in common: big dreams. Town also referred to as Dopewell, Hopelessville, Duhwell, and of course, Hope Smell. Then, just to double check my sources, I searched for a second definition and found that UrbanDictionary.com also defines Hopewell Valley as a small town in New Jersey full of crazy people who will prove to you that they are 10 times better than anyone else. Now, Hopewell's nicknames aren't something that I necessarily agree with, but I think that everyone in the audience will agree with me when I say that Hopewell kids do, in fact, dream big. When we walked into Hopewell 4 years ago, we had huge dreams. Some of us wanted to excel in sports, others in the arts, and others in academics. Whatever it was, we all had goals that seemed almost impossible to reach. For 4 years, we worked tirelessly to achieve these dreams. We poured our hearts and souls into our desires of becoming the best. Countless hours were spent perfecting our talents, and most of the time, those hours didn't start until after 2:45. In the pursuit of their dreams, everyone had to make sacrifices. But hey, isn't that what life's all about? We dedicated ourselves to the things we love, and look at what we've accomplished. We put on a dozen professional-level theatrical productions. Our robotics team was second to none. Model Who built a borehole in Kenya. SMAC continued to help families in the community. The TV production class brightened up every Friday morning. Recycling Club cleaned up the school every A and C day. Our athletes broke a number of school records. Barbecue for the Cure was an enormous success. The class officers organized an incredible prom. We had a state champion football team, and we saved Welcome Back. In the end, we don't need Urban Dictionary to tell us that we're crazy people who dream big, because we already know it. We are the class of 2014. We are those yahoos who won't take no for an answer. We have the guts to follow our dreams and achieve our goals. We are a class that has been determined to make its mark on Hopewell Valley, and we will surely not be forgotten. I just have one bone to pick with UrbanDictionary.com. They think that we run around trying to prove to everybody that we're number one, but they couldn't be more wrong. We do what we love, and we work incredibly hard. It's that hard work and incredible determination that makes this class so great. So you know what, Urban Dictionary? We don't need to prove that we're 10 times better than everyone else. Our big dreams and long list of achievements can do the talking. Keep it classy, seniors.
Good evening, everyone. After 37 years of teaching and learning in Hopewell Valley, I am finally graduating too. Here's some simple advice: to find someone who will love you through success and failure is to discover how little life has to do with either, said by Robert Brault. This is what my family and large extended family, who I love dearly, taught to me. Family connections matter more than anything. Your parents, guardians loved you enough to ask you where you were going, with whom, and what time you would be home. Remember to call your parents next year. Tell them you love them. Appreciate your parental love and guidance. Family matters more than anything. They hope and pray that you will only know the good feelings of life. Hug them and tell them that you are grateful for the life lessons that they have taught to you. Your family loves you no matter what. They shared with you compassion, understanding, and hope. It's called unconditional love. Thank your parents. 4 years ago, I selected a red t-shirt for your class, which you received at the freshman barbecue, a welcome to the Central High School gift, with what I thought was the perfect quote. Wonder is the beginning of wisdom, Socrates. Over the past 4 years, you have been taught lessons by teachers at Central High School that will stay with you for a lifetime. We are very proud of your many accomplishments. It is my privilege to present medals to our salutatorian and valedictorian for the class of 2014. Recipients, please come forward as I announce your name. Congratulations to our salutatorian, Russell Nicholson. Congratulations to our valedictorian, Haley Morin.
Congratulations, Haley. This one's for you. Dr. Smith, board members, Mr. Dare, faculty, friends, family, class of 2014. We are here. 4 years ago, on the first day of orientation,
Mr. Dare sat us down in the Performing Arts Center. He said to us, high school goes by quickly. You'll be graduating before you know it. And I clearly remember thinking, you gotta be kidding. High school is gonna be a marathon of PSATs, SATs, midterms, and finals. But he was right. It was quick, maybe too quick. And here we are. That day, Mr. Dare also said, these 4 years are short, so savor them. There was definitely a lot to savor. Yet every day, my parents asked me what I did at school. And every day, I always replied, not too much. Every day, that wasn't really true. My mom and dad had been waiting 4 years for an honest answer to their daily question. What did you do at school today? And tonight, I'd like to share that answer. Every day at Hopewell, I grew up a little bit more. And every day, I learned a little bit more. Not just history facts or math formulas, but life lessons, such as responsibility and honesty. Most of all, these 4 years at Hopewell have taught me that kindness is key, confidence is crucial, and a Hopewell education is exceptional. If you spend enough time strolling the hallways of our high school, you will quickly notice that kindness is contagious. Smiles spread sanguinity on a dreary Monday morning, and high fives celebrate even the smallest achievements. Our students give up their free time to help their teachers, and our teachers sacrifice their lunches to help our students. The kindness shared at Hopewell is often like the baton of a relay race. One friend holds a door until another friend comes along and says, it's okay, I got it. In this school, our school, where people help other people on a regular basis because they genuinely care, we have a good grasp on what really matters in life. Bill Clinton, in his recent speech at Maya Angelou's memorial, said that the things that really matter are dignity, work, love, and kindness. Hopewell students know this and show this, but I wish more people did too. As we move on and infect more people with our kindness, let's be confident. Last year, commencement speaker Nigel Bates reminded us that we should take a risk, even when people are telling us, don't do it, you don't know how. I'd like to echo that message with a saying we have in the music department, no shy. It means living without shyness, doing something without worrying about what other people think. In choir, no shy moments are a regular occurrence. Someone goes for that high note, and they either nail it or their voice cracks, and we all share a good laugh. Another good example of a no shy moment was back during freshman year, when we never quite managed to get our class float to the homecoming parade. Still, our officers walked down Dublin Road and Timberlane Drive with their heads held high. They asked me if I wanted to walk with them and support the class. I said, no, thank you. And I looked on as they tried to do their performance anyway, without music, without a float, but most importantly, without fear. Even though that happened a while ago, I still regret not taking the chance to get up there and help my friends. I should have lived no shy. We all should strive to live a no shy life, because Hopewell has made us into leaders, and leaders push past public perception to change the world. I know what you're thinking, whoa, change the world, that's some heavy stuff. But after graduating from Hopewell, I think it's possible for all of us. And I feel it's almost our responsibility. Class of 2014, we should remember how fortunate we are to have gone here for high school. Other schools don't have the same opportunities, athletic facilities, or teachers. Not every high school has three strong foreign exchange programs that give students a global perspective. Not every high school has a lighted turf field that brings students together for a night of boisterous school pride. And not every high school has a Mr. Parkinson, who writes a whole page response to his students' essays so that they know what they can work on. Or Ms. Solomon, whose language arts whose language and composition course can completely transform a student's writing. Or a radically awesome stats class, because after all, we have the one and only Mr. Schrager. Hopewell is not like other high schools, and we are not like other graduates. We have built a school community on kindness. We have shown we can live boldly, apart from external judgment and expectations. We have been given the gift of an unparalleled education. We are primed to make a difference. Now let's find something in the world that we feel needs to be changed and go out and change it. Thank you.
If you look on your program, you'll notice that Tony Persicilli is supposed to be next. But Ross Nicholson did such a good job that Tony didn't want to follow him, so he bailed. So, on that note, I'm Lisa Wolf, I'm the board president, and I'm going to skip ahead in your program. The best part of my job as board president is that I get to officially congratulate the graduating class of 2014. Recently, I sent a private message to one mom who was here today, and I commented that she must be so proud. She replied, quote, "It has truly been an honor and privilege to be a part of the school system for the past 8 years, but I truly believe it takes a village, and you've been part of that village." While her modesty underestimates her own contributions, her expressed gratitude is probably among the qualities that make her such a fabulous parent. It made me feel good to think that I could have made even the smallest difference. It is my humbling pleasure to be part of her village, of this village. Right now, the educational landscape is evolving, and sometimes not for the better. Yet, in our Hopewell bubble, things are stronger than ever. First, I'll admit, I asked Mr. Dare to make sure that we have perfect weather for graduation, and he delivered, thank you. The teachers and administration are singularly focused on providing a great education. Our school board annual self-review reported record levels of effectiveness. And outside of the schools, our students benefit from the larger community, the municipalities, local businesses, and our supportive neighbors. As a village, they partnered with the school district and delivered this beautiful field on which many students enjoyed great success. Our football team won the state championship, our color guard was named best overall, and our marching band and percussion did well in national competitions. Our students are thriving amidst the support of the village. Our new volleyball teams had a great inaugural year. We've broken records in wrestling, basketball, lacrosse. For the first time, our thespian troupe won many medals, and they, along with the future business leaders in DECA, will be competing nationally. Robotics and Comagination had amazing results. Frankly, even everyday activities are chock full of great experience. From reading the June Bulldog Reporter to discussing national policy with the AP Stats and AP Gov classes, today's program provides outside validation of our student quality. You are moving on to top schools throughout the country and internationally. Your schools include Brandeis, Brown, Carnegie Mellon, High Point, Franklin and Marshall, Princeton, Pomona, and Penn. The list goes on: Clemson, Indiana, Michigan State, Penn State, McGill, William and Mary. We are so proud of the path you all are choosing. In the 4 years since you have entered high school, our school has seen record student achievement. And in that time, the national economic outlook has improved, with unemployment dropping closer to 6, the stock and real estate markets rising. You are moving forward into an adulthood with an excellent foundation and the tools necessary for your success. The rest is up to you. While your family will always be your core support, our village is your extended family, and we are proud of all you have achieved. You are an important part of our village, Now, as you move forward with your lives, reflect on and appreciate what you have been given, and as you are increasingly able, please remember to pay it forward. Share your gifts. To quote the late Maya Angelou, if you get, give. If you learn, teach. Thank you.
Good evening. As principal of Hopewell Valley Central High School, I feel truly honored to have the opportunity to stand before our high school staff, the families and friends of our graduating seniors, and most of all, the members of the class of 2014 on their graduation night. I would like to begin by thanking our staff for all of your hard work and for dedicating yourselves to making this school year another successful one at Central High School. Your dedication to your profession, your commitment to the young people you teach, and your unwavering desire to help all of our students find success in the classroom does not go unnoticed. I would also like to take a moment to recognize five dedicated professionals who are retiring at the end of the current school year: Mr. Lang, Dr. Cheridea, Mr. Molinar, Ms. Shetler, and Mr. Anastasio. Thank you for the Thank you for the many years of service that you have given to this school district. You have touched the lives of students in many ways. Parents and guardians, you should take great pride in knowing that the guidance and love that you have given to the members of the class of 2014 will serve them well as they prepare to leave high school. Let me assure you that, like our teachers, you have been successful in nurturing your children into the very special young adults they are today. Hopefully, you all share in the feeling that your graduates have lived up to your expectations and rewarded you with their achievements. Members of the class of 2014, you may remember that when you attended Timberlane Middle School, you were one of the classes that participated in the Challenge Day activities. As part of Challenge Day, you were encouraged by your teachers to follow Gandhi's challenge, which was to be the change that you want to see in the world. Now let me share another challenge with you. We all live in a world filled with rules. Some rules are spoken and some are unspoken. We follow those rules most of our lives. The challenge that I am presenting to you this evening is to know when, where, and how to be the exception to those rules. Your challenge as you graduate this evening is to be just that, the exception to the rule. It's an odd statement from someone who has always been a rule follower and asked you repeatedly during the past 4 years to follow the rules at Central High School. And for the most part, you did. But some of the greatest single accomplishments and historical events that have been and will be remembered for generations to come were feats of courage and determination from people who simply decided not to follow the rules, in many cases, to be the exception to the rule. Rosa Parks decided one day not to follow the rules and to be the exception to the rule. Nelson Mandela, Mahatma Gandhi, Amelia Earhart, Martin Luther King Jr., and many more courageous individuals all led their lives deciding to be the exception to the rule. And how about as recently as 2012, when a 14-year-old girl named Malala Yousafzai decided to be the exception to the rule? She was the young woman who was shot in the head at close range by a member of the Taliban because she believed that she had the right to an education. Maybe it's unreasonable to think that we can all be the next Rosa Parks, Nelson Mandela, or Malala, for that matter. Maybe it's unreasonable to think that all 300 of you can go out and change the world by being the exception to the rule. How about instead, if we leave this evening with the mindset that although we can't change the world, at least we can change the world we live in by knowing when to be the exception to the rule? How? let me first remind you that you all share something in common with every one of the aforementioned people who changed history. You have a voice. You have the ability to speak out against injustices. You have the ability to speak up when you know that someone, or more importantly, something is just plain wrong. You have the ability to be the exception to the unwritten rules, which often tell us to passively stand by when someone is being treated with disrespect. You all have the ability and the responsibility to speak up when you hear someone make a statement that demeans or hurts you or someone close to you or even someone you don't know. If you were to do that, you would be impacting the world in a way that is very important but difficult to measure. When we see injustices in this world, it's important to find the courage and strength to stand up for what we know is right and just. Dr. King once said, "Our lives begin to end as soon as we become silent about the things that really matter." It's no longer okay to be silent about the things that really matter. Maybe Sarah Bareilles says it best in the lyrics to the song Brave. Everybody's been there. Everybody's been stared down by the enemy, fallen from the fear, and done some disappearing. Bowed down to the mighty. Don't run. Just stop holding your tongue. Say what you want to say, and let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you be brave with what you want to say, and let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you be brave. In closing, it's now time for me to follow Sarah's lead and say what I want to say. Dr. Smith, members of the Board of Education, I have the privilege and pleasure to present to you the Hopewell Valley Central High School Class of 2014 for the conferring of their diplomas. As principal of the high school and with the faculty to bear witness, I am verifying that the candidates before you have fulfilled the graduation requirements established by the Hopewell Valley Regional School District and the state of New Jersey. Seniors, I wish you well. Seniors, I wish you well. You are truly an amazing class. You are all very special, and I will miss you a lot. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Tom Smith, Superintendent of Schools. For those of you who are following along in your program, I am the last speaker. I am last because I am responsible for certifying that the students sitting in front of me have met the state requirements for a New Jersey high school diploma. Prior to doing this, I do have some brief remarks. But first, I'd just like to say thank you to those people who were so quick acting when the student went down earlier. That really shows what Hopewell is about, that it was so quick that we had 10 people around who were ready to help out. And of course, only in Hopewell, when you ask for a doctor, 15 people come out so quickly, so it's... Graduates, this is your night. But please know that for the rest of us, your accomplishments bring us happiness, satisfaction, and validation. Over the past 4 years, we, community, have shared in your accomplishments. But I also realize that as parents, even with all the accomplishments that you've heard tonight, we still see students who don't make their bed, don't put their clothes in the hamper. We also sometimes listen to the media who questions this new generation and the ability of American students to participate on a global scale. But I must say, I consider myself very lucky. I've been very fortunate to have interacted with so many students in this senior class. Not only the students that were involved in Mr. E's Snowy video, but also the students who served on various committees and presented to the board and the administration. I can say without reservation that these are some of the best and brightest students I've come across. They are bright, articulate, well-mannered, and represent you and the district very well. You should be very proud and confident that they are prepared to make their mark on the world. Graduates, I know you've received a lot of advice tonight, but I'd just like to say one more thing. I know many of you have dinner planned tonight or graduation ceremony or graduation party this weekend. I ask just at some point during these events, you find the person who made a difference in your life, who helped you, who inspired you, who motivated you, and just say thank you. Remember that you didn't do it alone. We're all in this together. Parents, know that the legacy that these students leave behind leave me very optimistic about the ability of our students to contribute on a global scale, even in these most difficult times. And I believe the future for Hopewell is incredibly bright, thanks to the excellent foundation that you and your children have built. We are continually reviewing our educational programs so our students are prepared for the demands of an advancing technology, and trust that you have an excellent school board who is committed to asking the right questions and driven to provide an outstanding education to our students as they help guide us into the future. Together, we will ensure that our graduates for the next 100 years are as strong as the graduates who are leaving us this evening. With that, I say the official words, Principal Dare. I certify that these attending graduates have met the graduation requirements for the state of New Jersey. You may award their diplomas. Students, congratulations, good luck, and be safe.
John Joseph King IV.
Maha Malik.
Anshu Sinha.
Patricia Rose Buck.
Erica Michelle West.
Jessica Abrams.
Kieran Singh Aluwalia.
Rebecca Louise Ahmad.
Erin Elizabeth Amantia.
Gabriel Cornelou Andre.
Sergey Andreev.
Emma Aislinn Archibald.
Ian James Archibald.
Aaron Sheridan Austin.
Connor. Harry James Barr.
Anne Demarest Bancroft.
Ryan Wayne Bass.
Hunter Belmont.
Graylin Claudia Bennett.
Kyle Mark Bennison.
Casey Benvignati.
Taylor Brooke Blagg.
Hannah Claire Bowers.
Elizabeth Ann Boyce Giacino. Samantha Mary Brandberg.
Joseph Peter Braun.
Catherine Blair Brents.
Camille Bridger.
Daphne Brianna Brower.
Casey Eden Brock.
Joseph Gennaro Buono.
Ross Colin Burrows.
Shelby Marie Butler.
Michelle Gretchen Campbell.
Gabrielle Rose Canavera.
Ethan James Capello.
Evan Carlton.
Hannah Elise Carpenter.
Brandon Alexander Caswell.
Bryce Winfield Caton.
Carly Denise Cavalier.
James Chadwell.
Blake Miguel Chavez.
Richard Choi.
Jason Philip Cruz.
Timothy Robert Cianfano.
Katie Lee Sirianni Jones.
Haley Citrone.
Dean Patrick Clark.
Brian Patrick Clem.
Evan Collins.
Samantha Lee Kalura.
Jacob Stryker Cordayou.
Ryan Dejak.
David Robert Dolling.
Peter Lindell Dalton.
Miles Leonard Davis.
Sophia Davis.
Danielle Marissa Deering.
Tommy Devlin.
Simi Dar.
Rachel Olivia Dickstein.
Michael DiDonato.
Ryan Patrick Ellinger.
Catherine Elliott.
Sarah Marcella Ely.
Amanda Erickson.
Austin Jeffrey Fellows.
Sarah Victoria Ferguson.
Catherine Fletcher.
John Henry Fowler.
Christina Rose Francis.
Braden Gack.
Samantha Lynn Gallagher.
Erin Ann Garrity.
Andre Michael Gaughan.
Leanna Jean Gerstacker.
Isabella Mia Gervasoni.
David Forrest Gifford.
Alyssa K. Gill.
Dylan James Gladue.
Sarah Katie Glover.
Eleanor Ruth Goldgar.
Sarah Michelle Gavantes.
Andrew Joseph Graziano.
Abigail Grenier.
Turner David Greenwald.
Vaughn Smith Grundy.
Laurent Ginna.
Jack Christian Guido.
Sean Lucas Gunther.
Taylor Ann Guttisman.
Kara Ann Hagman.
Anne Marie Haig.
Elizabeth Marie Hansen.
Shannon Carida Harkins.
Shannon Harney.
Okira Emeka Harris.
Mitchell Jason Hartel.
John Emmett Hassett.
Emma Anne Hastings.
Ethan Joseph Hatke.
Alexander Brooks Hawkins.
Josie Kaplan Healy.
Kylie Middleton Heck.
Julia Lauren Herzberg.
Andrew Thomas Hildebrandt.
Brian John Hone.
Anna Elizabeth Hollander.
Danielle Holiday.
Annalise Simone Holashi.
Darren Mackenzie Howell.
Jonathan Heranek.
Sloan Alana Courtney Hughes.
Andrew Thomas Hunt.
Aaron Dylan Jackson.
Anshul Jain.
Hope Jordan Jantorno.
Connor Thomas Jastrzebski.
Lindsay Johnson.
Nicholas Johnson.
You're gonna go solo, honey. You're gonna go solo.
Jacob Nicholas Jones.
Sabrina Joseph.
Matthew Michael Jurison.
Romina Elena Calmeyer.
Kunal Amit Kapadia.
Shayna Tilly Carlin.
Benjamin Katz.
Kyle Kelly.
Sean Cornelius Kent.
Bilal Khan.
Jesse Wilson Kinneman.
Lucy Grace Kitson.
Zachary Aaron Klim.
Daniel Redmond Kling.
Joseph Kozwara.
Stephen Michael Corwin.
Jonathan Nicholas Krolik.
Garrett Howard Cruz.
Tyler Lamb.
Kyle Lanning.
John Joshua Lee.
Sarah Elizabeth Leeper.
Thomas Martin Lehman Borer.
Daniel Lester.
Amanda Kelly Little.
Ian Livernotch.
Shelby Don Logsden.
Breton Tatler Long.
Stephanie Kayla Lopez.
Brandon Liu.
Brennan Michael Lytell.
Courtney Michelle McFarlane.
Haley Mann.
Aaron Mackenzie Mancuso.
Maria Mans.
Colin Marino.
Michael Kent Markulak.
Michael Martin.
Benjamin Marks.
Emily Anderson Marks.
Alisa Ann Mastriani.
Alexis Mateka.
Benjamin Eric Matheny.
Ryan John Matthews.
Elijah May.
John Mazur the second.
Connor Patrick McAvania.
Jake McLean.
Kelsey McClintock.
Carolyn Renee McDonough.
Benjamin Mendelson.
Lane Richard Meyer.
Gregory Mealy.
Marion Adele Miller.
Michelle Claire Miller.
Scott Allen Miller.
David Morris Milner.
Imogen Abigail Mills.
Zachary Michael Moranowick.
Peter Dominic Mitrano.
Miguel Angel Maledo.
Haley Morin.
Kimberly Morocco.
Olivia Ann Morpeth.
Jocelyn Marie Morton.
Hunter Ray Muller.
Michaela Murr.
Ian Patrick Murray.
Gina Marie Noel Musso.
Shamir Bin Navid.
Kellyanne Nemec.
Benjamin New.
Russell Matthew Nicholson.
Madison Ann Nicolau.
Andrew Heath Nieder.
Laura Elizabeth Niederer.
Catherine Mary Nyby.
Michael Joseph O'Donnell.
Christian William Bjorseth Olaya.
Evan Ordonez.
Everett Orr.
Amelia Rose Ortman.
Oliver Oshman.
Noah Jonathan Auslander.
Kevin Samuel Parker.
Kimberly Ann Parker.
Suzanne Sarah Pashley.
Connor Frank Pasquito.
Sarah Peck.
Morgan Elaine Peterson.
Michelle Perkins.
Justin David Perrone.
Craig Allen Persing Jr.
Molly Peterson.
Jared Pazillo.
Hank Piper.
Cooper O'Rourke Place.
Taylor DiStefano Ponton.
Elizabeth Policarin.
John Quinlan.
Leonardo Joseph Raker.
William Thomas Redman.
Caitlin Richter.
Connor Ian Ritley.
Brianna Danielle Rivkin.
Trevor Roberto.
Virginia Barlow Rocky.
Patrick Joseph Roderman.
Nicholas Hancock Royval.
Carly Alexandra Romanchuk.
Colin Russell.
Zara Marie Sufdar.
Owen Connor Salmon.
Yeah! Anne Pauline Sankey.
Charles Claiborne Seraphin.
Logan Schnorbus.
Angela Scott.
Jared Scott.
Sarah Ford Semple.
Julia Francis Erler Senkowski.
Sierra Ann Shade.
Kaylin Rose Shimko.
Andrew Henry Sieber.
Morgan Elizabeth Civi.
Matthew Skevington.
Kenneth Smart.
Holly Elizabeth Smith.
Lucas Smith.
William Joseph Smith.
Brenna Ann Smotzer.
Brandon Sobel.
Owen Moore Stevens.
Ryan Stingle.
Zoe Alexandra Stork.
Oliver Clark Stratton.
Jenny Ann Strick.
Ward Taggart.
Eric James Tater.
Thomas Teachin.
Justine Sydney Thompson.
Kevin Joseph Thompson.
William Thompson.
Zoe Alice Thompson.
Zoe Marissa Thompson.
Akua Tiku.
Claudia Toto.
Yeah. Roger Cicero Toussaint.
Justin Samuel Volsky.
Annette Sontag von Jalinski.
Jackie Walker.
Alice Yaji Wang.
Cole Jarrett Warner.
Brian Wasserman.
Abigail Carter Watterson.
Carlina Rose Weidel.
Trevor Weidman.
David Austin Wells.
Mark Wenner.
Tyler Grant Willie.
Amanda Christy Winand.
Jacob Wuthridge.
Colin John Yaus.
Deborah Yu.
Andrew Joshua Yuska.
Samantha Flag Yusko.
Riley Elizabeth Zealous.
Andrew James Valcarcel.
Caleb Daffalou.
I don't want to try it. tonight, and may your dreams be realized. If the thundercloud passes rain, so let it rain.
To the end of town.
are to assist putting the stands back on the rack and getting them back to the band room. Please. Percussionists, everyone helps to make sure all the equipment gets back. Don't take one thing back and then leave. Help so I'm not staying here by myself.